I just got this ladybug out of my garden. That's why I don't have any aphids, because I have ladybugs. Hi, I'm Lina Mumma. In this video, I'm going to show you how I harvest my greens when I have a aphids infestation. And I'm gonna talk also why you shouldn't kill them and leave them for ladybugs or for other insects. I joined several non-vegan gardening groups, and what I see all the time is that how people just almost religiously kill all kind of insects. Some of them even hunt them at night. They have some kind of night vision light, hunt for those bugs and squash them. So these people probably they don't want to spray chemicals, so they manually kill bugs. I don't know, it seems to me very violently, and if I would have to do that, it would certainly affect me as a person. It's affect my seeing myself as a human, I guess. It will affect my morals. There is even studies that if you suppress your compassion, then you will feel, I think, less morally about yourself. I will post link below. So I have a compassion towards all animals. This is one of the reasons why I grow my food. And because all food in the store literally come packaged in the plastic. It's so hard to shop for food without plastic, even if it's in a bulk section or if it's in a just produce section without plastic. They probably grown with plastic, they shipped with plastic, like even fruits has a like cardboard box but lines with plastic. As a result, we have a massive plastic pollution, since plastic does not biodegrade. Millions of animals killed each year after ingesting plastic or getting entangled in it. So this is my reason why I started to grow my garden. My goal is to grow my food without killing any insects, and so far so good. I always be able to find solution for problem. I had a aphids infestation, and I just wait, and then ladybugs show up. So just matter of time, a few days, I can survive without greens. So I get sick of them anyway. So sometimes it's good to have a rest. I don't mean that I literally get sick of greens. I just sometimes don't want to eat them. My goal also to coexist with nature, not to dominate. I know I can buy a spray and kill all kind of bugs, but the problem with that, if you buy a spray, even soap, even organic, you spray your soap to kill bugs, you kill also beneficial insects. So then you will just have problem continuously. You will never win this fight. So it just, I rather sacrifice maybe a few plants or a few times I be without greens, and then ladybugs will come and do the job for me, and I will just have clean greens. I think it's a much smarter way. I don't really want to kill any insects intentionally, so I'm always searching and finding ways how to avoid that. So, and here is my little tip, and it also saves you a lot of water, and I think it's more convenient. So all you need is strainer or bowl and hose and some greens in your garden. That's it. So what I'm doing, I'm just take scissors and cut the greens. And it's very clean right now, so I don't see any insects. But when sometimes I have just aphids just everywhere. So I started to grow my garden about a year ago, and I had that aphids infestation maybe twice, and I didn't do absolutely nothing. I ask people what they do, and the common answer I get that, oh, just spray with soap and water or some other chemical. So, and I'm not doing that because I don't really think it's a good way to create healthy ecosystem. Also, if I kill them, what other insects gonna eat? Then if I kill other insects, what birds will eat? What other animals will eat? So my thinking is not to kill them and let other insects to eat them, and other insects eat other insects, and then birds eat, and then other animals. I'm herbivore. I don't feel like I want to eat insects or kill them, and then I actually, if I would kill them intentionally, I would feel bad about myself. So I don't really want to feel bad about myself also. And then cats will come, and then they eat birds. This is feral cats. I have many of those feral cats in my yard. I feed them out of the dumpster. pet store dumpster, if you're interested how to feed your pet. Yeah, check out my video. I will post link below. So, and then those feral cats, because I feed them and I pet them. Then they bring me some killed birds, and it's so disgusting. When I open the door and I see on my doormat or near my door the ripped off bird, I feel like a puke. It's so disgusting, but they don't understand that I'm herbivore. So I'm not angry at them. I just take a hose, bring right away into the garden, and I just take a shower settings and gently turn on. And then I cut the greens. And then usually they're on the back side. And then I just gently wash them. And all this water stay in the garden. And I think I don't kill them this way. If I maybe turn on very strong, maybe it hurts them. But if I just very gentle shower, like a little rains, and I think they're safe. And then they can climb to other leaf, and then when ladybugs comes, and they're all here. So also what very important, people sometimes do not understand that you have to have a lot of aphids for ladybugs to come. They eat 50-60 aphids a day, and plus other insects. So you have to have a lot in your garden for them to come and do their job. So if they see just few little aphids, they will leave your garden. They're not interested in some kind of just few calorie meals. They want buffet, like real buffet. So it's like, even if you invite me to some restaurant and there will be a few calorie meal, I would never come back there. So just remember, lots of calories, lots of bugs they want. They don't want little fancy meal. Also, I'm not suggesting to buy ladybugs. There is many reasons why you shouldn't buy them. I will post an article in the link below why you shouldn't buy ladybugs. So you just wait, have enough food, provide them with enough aphids, and then they will come. Just be patient. So I'm gonna collect my greens. Easy way, I don't need to shower them anymore, because I guess I planted maybe some beneficial plant also, and I don't have aphids. I have other stuff, but not aphids. So if you like my video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe, leave a comment below, and let me know if you're interested to find the way of how to biologically or ethically to reduce your insect population that they're eating your bug or eating your greens. And I will also try to find the way. I'm always searching for new ways how to grow food without killing peacefully. That's why my name is EcoPeaceful. Not my name, my channel name. Thank you for watching. Bye.